Throughout history and across all cultures, whether it's a tribal ritual, the two-step, or twerking, we all have a personal way of expressing ourselves on the dance floor, or at home in front of the mirror. And while some of us are seemingly a lot better than others, the question remains, are these expressions actually individual or part of an embedded human code? Why are we so drawn to dance, and is it really equivalent to a human mating call? More importantly, does dancing increase your potential to get some? From a viewer's perspective, dance can be pleasurable to watch for many of the same reasons music is enjoyable to listen to. But it was the science legend Charles Darwin who first suggested that dance could be part of mating rituals and entangled with the evolution and survival of our species. But if this is true, the ability to dance must somehow relate to the ability to survive and reproduce. So, does it? It turns out that early humans who were coordinated, symmetrical, and rhythmic were seen as more viable to a mate because these traits were often linked to survival, the ability to run faster, defend against prey, and ultimately survive. And dancing just happens to be an outward manifestation and display of many of these qualities, a quick external way of documenting and proving your fitness in order to attract a mate. This desire to dance can even be seen in babies as early as 5 months old, bopping to a beat. In fact, many species use dance or movement to swoon the opposite sex, from spiders to a variety of birds and even bees, which use dance moves to communicate entire messages. But why are humans compelled to dance to music? It likely has something to do with the fact that many of the brain's reward systems are directly connected to the motor areas. For example, music stimulates the cerebellum at the base of the brain, which is involved in the timing and coordination of movement. In a contemporary sense, dance is known to show confidence and fearlessness, and sometimes intoxication. But most importantly, movements associated with good dancing are indicative of good health and reproductive potential. And in many cases, the human courtship ritual in our natural habitat of a nightclub mirrors that of animals in the wild. This gives being an animal on the dance floor a new meaning, except our liquid courage doesn't come from the local waterhole. Ironically, many men feel as though they can't dance or that dancing isn't for them. But in most animals, the males must impress the female. So what is good dancing then? Scientists have actually studied which male dance movements were most attractive to women. Interestingly, it was seen that twisting, bending, and fluid movements of the core body region, like the torso, neck, and head, garnered the most positive attention from women. Showing variability, flexibility, and creativity was perceived as good dancing. On the other hand, repetitive, rigid, and twitchy movements weren't particularly attractive, sometimes called dad dancing. And truthfully, your dad probably dances a little slower and more rigid than his youthful counterpart because, simply put, he isn't as youthful or fit anymore. So, whether you're in a club, a bar, or your own living room, engage and embrace your animal instincts. And if you're asked where you got those moves, just say, "Millions of years of evolution have led to this dance, baby." Who knew science could be so groovy? This episode of ASAP Science is supported by Audible.com, the leading provider of audiobooks with over 100,000 downloadable titles across all types of literature. If you'd like to learn more about evolution, I recommend the book The Greatest Show on Earth by Richard Dawkins. You can download this audiobook or another of your choice for free at audible.com/ASAP. Special thanks to Audible for making these videos possible and offering you a free audiobook at audible.com/ASAP. And subscribe for more weekly science videos.